Hi, so this video is going to be about the electrical system for the Eberspacher. Just before we go out and look at the van, I thought we'd just run through what that consists of. I've got this, it's page 20 of the Marine Guide. So we've got our heater, and so far we've mounted it. We've got our fuel lines in it. We've got his exhaust and his intake. What we need to do now is electrics. There's the loom itself on the unit. You get about 8 inches to cable, if that, and then we've got a connector block just here. From that connector block, we've got the main loom itself, which splits into three parts. We've got our one line that's going to go to our connector, to our controller unit, whether that be a 701 type,
a 301,
whether it's one of the new R-Starts or Easy Start controllers, they're all the same. What we also have up here, we have the place where we'd attach our external sensor, which I've already got fitted to my unit. If anyone's interested in how to fit that or sourcing anything, just drop a message in the comments. I'll quite happily go through doing that. It's quite a simple procedure. Off that same line, we've got our power supply cable, which we're going to have a look at in a minute. 24 volts, depending on your unit. It has its own internal fuse box with the space for three fuses. I've only got two in there. And then we've got our wire that goes to our fuel pump. The one that goes to our fuel pump is obviously going to have to be ran to our fuel pump. So that one's going to have to go through, in my case, the bulkhead of the vehicle. In your case, it could be through the floor of the vehicle. Just got to get to the outside. We'll have a look at how to do that. And that's it. It's a pretty simple system. If your unit's new, your connector, you'll have to put on yourself all of these. So you're quite good for feeding cables. To an older unit, you'll have to cut and then rejoin your cables. If you are rejoining cables, it's best to solder them and put heat shrink over them, just so that you get a good solid seal and it's not likely to get dirt and moisture in there, more likely to last. But you could just join them with crimps. Brilliant. So let's go have a look at the van, eh? So to start off the electrical system, we're going to need a power supply, and in this case I've got a leisure battery. I do have an integral fuse box in my van, which I installed myself, so I kind of know how it works, and when I did that I was sure to leave myself a spare fuse. So here on my list we can see I've got an air heater when fitted. We don't actually have to fuse the supply to the Eberspacher, as on the cable that goes to the Eberspacher we do have two internal fuses, which are nicely packaged inside their own fuse box. We could just supply a live to this power cable. We don't actually need to put a fuse in it. It's just easier for me, with me having a fuse spare, to do it that way. Onto the other side of that fuse box goes the cable from the wiring loom. As you can see here, we've got the brown cable, which is for the negative feed, and then we have a fuse one and fuse two. I've got these marked up. It is as simple as the thicker wire goes to the thicker wire in the fuse box. You can kind of just do it off the gauge of the wire, but I did label everything up. The other wire is for the ADR unit, which we're not going to look at in the fitting of this van. Fantastic. So I said I'm using a leisure battery here for my feed for my Eberspacher. The reason being that the Eberspacher does draw a decent amount of power, and if I was to use the van's main battery, while the engine wasn't running, that I'd drain that battery down. It could be that the next day my van wouldn't start. So definitely any ancillary things you add, always worth running off a leisure battery.
When deciding on a leisure battery, it's worth having in your mind, if you are going to add a heater in the future, that you do have some spare amp hours left on top of what you might need, just for those cold long nights. So let's get to connecting that together. I've got to attach the negative feed to the negative. In my case, that's on the fuse box, and the positive to the positive. On your van or vehicle, this could be directly onto a battery or onto a bus bar, however you've got it. As long as we're getting them the right way around, there's not really much to concern ourselves with.
So now I've got my cable running from my ECU. Just comes in from down here somewhere. Shoots up right across the top. I had to split the sheath covering the thing up, really simple, just literally pulled it apart. I didn't bother using a knife, you could do, but I'm always worried I'll cut cables. So I literally just pulled it apart, taking the negative feed, hooked that to my negative block, and all of these are negative at the top, not positive at the bias.
Clip that into there, and obviously I just need to place a fuse in. This then runs through, just tied it away to my fuse box for the Eberspacher one. I think it's worth keeping two separate fuses for either of these, and I don't have space in my fuse box here for it. So all I'll do is I'll put a combined fuse in, so I'll put a 25 amp fuse in here, and that should give me more than enough capacitor. The way I've tied the cables away is literally get these blocks, super simple, the cable tie just goes through the top of them, put a screw through the centre, and I've just, so there's one there, there's another one there, just holding. Really, really useful, cost a couple of pence. If you've not got them, you could literally just use cable tie these with a hammer and nail. You could just cable tie them to things, like it doesn't really matter if the cable's flat around. I'm just always a bit worried if things wobble, they'll break, so all I've got to do. Add a little Eberspacher. Whew. Fuse box cover on.
So now that we've got the power supply to our Eberspacher in place, we need to route the cable for the fuel pump. The fuel pump in my case is under the bonnet, so we need to get there, and to do that I'm planning on running the cable behind here. There's already an existing loom behind this. To get this off, it's simply a case of popping out these little clips here with a screwdriver. Four screws on this piece to remove this, two screws here to pop this panel off, and two screws here to remove this. That'll give us plenty of room to run that cable out of sight, so we don't have to worry about catching our legs. Plus, looks a lot more professional that way. Then what we're going to do is we'll run the cable behind the dash and through the bulkhead. So let's get started on that.
So, I've got my cable in, it's going through the bulkhead behind the pedals, just got to make sure it doesn't interfere in the pedals, and then here with the covers off, I've just routed it through the existing wiring loom holders. There it goes, and it goes all the way back through to the unit. Obviously I ran this from the unit control side through the bulkhead, but we're just seeing it in reverse order. So here's where that cable comes through the bulkhead, just where this rubber hose passes through behind the dash. Nice hole already made there, so it saves us the trouble of making a new one. You can see where it's attached there, so you can find it on your van. We've got the cable fastened back together, put the end on. I've soldered this, put some heat shrink on it, and all we're going to do is then connect that up to our pump. We'll have to route this through just to keep it out of the way, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem. So I'll get that sorted, and then we'll have a look at what I've done. So I've got that cable in, got it connected back together. See there where the tape is where I've soldered it. I've just literally cable tied it to route it through the engine bay. All you've got to do is be careful it doesn't touch anything too hot, and there it is plugged in. I've put a bit of electrical tape on the connector just to try and waterproof a bit. The Citroens do have a bit of an issue up here with water getting in behind this panel. Mine's been sticker flexed in the past, try and stop that happening, but it's better to be safe than sorry. So one thing there to be aware of.
Decided that this is where the controller is going to live, is just here in that position. Things to consider is you're going to have to drill a fairly hole in the centre, two holes at the top. So you've got a couple of holes to drill. With mine, I'm going to drill a fairly large hole. If this is a new unit, before putting the connector on the end, you would literally push the cable through a tiny hole and then you'd put the connector on the end. This isn't the original connector, obviously. It's a nice swish single connector. If you buy the unit new, the reason mine's got this on it is I've used this controller in three different vehicles now as I've moved units and things like that. And unfortunately I don't have the female connector to connect to the wiring loom, so I've had to get a bit inventive in the end. I've not found I've had any problems by doing this. They don't seem overly sensitive to the connections, but obviously you just need to make sure that the connections are solid and just check. On the other side I've got the corresponding pieces in here, the main wires that are of importance. We've got the yellow and solid red wires, we've got the grey and red striper, we've got the blue and white striper, and we've got the brown and white. The black you can see here, and this red that's bridged across to this grey, are actually part of a temperature sensor I've installed from Latonkis Varnish. I'll put a link to it in the description. Really good temperature sensor, and it only costs a fraction of the Eberspacher one, but it's the same unit. How those wires correspond, it's pretty simple. So blue and white, blue and white, Graham red to graham red, the brown, I believe, to our brown and white, yellow to yellow, red to red. Clip them all in, and that should be this good to go.
So connecting the loom to the heater is pretty simple. We've got a connector on our heater and we've got the connector on our loom. We take the little red pin on the connector on the loom and we pull that out, not all the way, just slightly. That should allow us to push the two together, just being careful that the little lugs are in the right place. Once the push firm is together, just press it down and it clicks into position. And that's now locked in. That's our fuel pump installed and our controller, the wiring loom plugged in. So once we've got power on, that's us good to go. So fantastic. Thanks again for watching. The electrics aren't too difficult. Any questions regarding anything we've covered or anything I've done, just drop it in the comments box. I'll get back to you on that. If you've not already, subscribe. Get on that. It'll keep you informed when the videos become available. The next video is going to be on initial running, testing the system, just checking everything, any way we can improve it. And then we've got to take care of the internal ducting to get the hot air to where we need it. Thanks for watching. Cheers. Bye.